This is the Galileo supercomputer located in Cineca, Bologna, Italy. It has 516 nodes in its disposal, each having two 8-core CPUs. That results in more than 8,000 available cores. Each core is equipped with 8GB of RAM, which adds up to more than 46TB of RAM in total. Staying with memory, Galileo has 2PB large scratch disk. All this hardware makes up the total power of more than 1 petaflops. As of today, Galileo is the 281st fastest computer in the world. And as you can imagine, all this performance takes up a lot of power, 2825 kilowatts when Galileo is in its full charge. This lays ground to one of the most common problems managing HPC facilities all around the world, energy efficiency. Using the Internet of Things technologies, a monitoring system was built by the good guys from Unibow, codename Examon. Examon measures more than 50 metrics every 2 to 30 seconds. You can get the data ranging from CPU core load through system utilization to the cluster temperature. But there was something missing. Something to visualize all this data in a meaningful way. This is where I come into play. I was tasked with building a web app which will take all the data we gather from Galileo and visualize it. And therefore, Examon Web was born. It's an application built on top of Angular framework with Python backend. The app connects to multiple data sources, combines them and visualizes them. A picture is worth a thousand words, so let's do a quick walkthrough of the Examon Web. We start off on the job lookup page. A job is a routine which allocates a selected portion of the cluster and then runs your code on it. Each job has its unique ID. We can use this ID here to go directly to our job. We can pick up an active job from the list. It's also possible to view a finished job with even more data about it. I have a job finished, so let's take a look at it. We can get some basic info about the job itself, such as the user or queue it is running in. Next, we have some times here. Each job goes through a specific life cycle, but let's skip it for now. Some cool stuff about it. Right next to it, we can see allocated resources such as CPUs, RAM or MPI processes. We also know exactly which cores and nodes were allocated for this job and the scheduler assigned us, for example here, node 116 and all cores from it. The last part on this dashboard is average core load for all allocated cores. This way we can quickly say if it works well and effectively. For example here we can see that all cores but one worked perfectly. Let's move to the performance dashboard. This shows us how our code performs in a much more detailed way. We have a lot of info here, such as cores load, IPS, cache misses and so on, all in nice interactive graphs. You can zoom in, for example, or see the legend. Next is energy dashboard. Here we can see the power consumption, temperatures and CPU and DRAM power. This reminds us that running our code requires quite a lot of energy. Now we have all the info we need about a job, such as system load, temperatures, effectiveness and so on. But what if we want to see the data about the whole cluster? For this, we move to the public dashboard. First of all, on top we can specify in what time range we want to see the data. We will stay in 30 minutes for now. On the top, we can see some basic numbers about the cluster and the jobs that have been run there. Below that are another charts showing us the cluster load, temperature and power consumption per node. Personally, I love the cluster load chart. Now, let's move to the coolest part of the app. 3D model. Once the model is loaded, we can see a 3D model of the Galileo cluster itself. You can see that the nodes are color-coded in some way. Right now it shows ambient temperature. That is temperature of air flowing into the node. Right here, blue is around 12 degrees, ranging to red, topping at around 28. We can walk through the model using pan, zoom or rotation. Blender Master at Cineca is provided even with cool transformations of the model itself. We can open the cluster to see everything perfectly in one view or look from the top of the cluster. Next, if you're bored enough with the ambient temperature, we can switch to other metrics, such as memory load. Did I mention that everything happening in the model is real time? No? Well, it is. Using MQTT, all the needed data is delivered straight to us and rendered. With the memory load, we can see the changes on certain nodes quite often.
And that's all, folks. Thanks for watching and I hope you enjoyed the walkthrough.